Welcome back, students. So let's continue with the reading part of your story, right? A Midsummer Night's Dream. Okay, it is. I'll just read it. I've already given you the summary in my previous video. I'll be reading it and I'll be explaining it in my own words. See, it was the custom in ancient Athens for the father of the family to decide whom his daughter should marry. Now, I've already told you that it was a custom, right? It was a father's will where he would send his daughter, or it was a father's will whom he really wanted his daughter to marry. And there was this thing that if the daughters, you know, they deny or if they disagree with their father, then of course the king had the authority to kill their daughter. And there was also a law that if a daughter refused to take the husband chosen for her, her father could cause her to be put to death. So even it was allowed by a father to kill his or his own daughter or to put her to death. At the time this tale begins, the ruler, or okay, now understand, tale is a story, right? So at the time this tale begins, the ruler of Athens, Prince Theseus, was about to marry Hippolyta, queen of the Amazons. Please understand, and was arranging the ceremonies and the feast for the occasion. So the opening of the scene starts with the ceremonies and, you know, how this prince and the princess, they were preparing for the ceremonies of their own marriage, which was about to held, or which was about to take place in the 4 days. While he was thus busying himself, an old citizen of Athens named Euges came before him with a complaint about his daughter Hermia. She would not accept, he said, the husband chosen for her, a young man named Demetrius, because she did not love him, but loved another young man, Athenian, named Lysander. So here father is making this complaint to a king that my daughter is not ready to marry the one whom I have chosen for her, right? And my daughter Hermia is in love with Lysander, the other man. However, I have chosen Demetrius for my daughter. Further, Lysander returned her love. And of course, Lysander was also in love with Hermia. But Zeus was determined that she should marry Demetrius or die according to the law. Now this old man, he was determined, he wanted it. He wanted to tell the king that, see, I want my daughter either to marry Demetrius or to die according to the law. Though the prince told her that it was her duty to obey her father, she said she was not willing to do so. Now the girl, maybe she was pretty bold. At that time, she could actually refuse her father and the king. She told the king straight away that she cannot do that as she was in love with Lysander. She also pointed out that Demetrius had won the love of Helena, a friend of hers, whom it was therefore his duty to marry. And apart from that, she even disclosed the fact to the king that Demetrius was actually loved by one of her friends, Helena, and decently, Demetrius should be married to that girl, Helena. The prince, more merciful than the law, gave judgment in the case that Hermia should either agree to marry Demetrius or pass the rest of her life in a religious house away from home and friends. Now, of course, the prince was, kind-hearted. He was generous. He was merciful. And that is why, rather than getting a daughter killed, he told Hermia that either she should marry Demetrius or she would be sent to a nun's place, a place where she would stay unmarried throughout her life. There were 4 days before the prince's own marriage. Hermia was allowed those 4 days in which to give her answer. Nehemiah had 4 days to give her answer, and by that time Prince was preparing for his marriage. Right? Okay, we'll continue with the rest in the next video. Thank you.